Good day. This is the news hour coming to you from Metro TV. I am Emmanuel Oladipo. First, the headlines. INEC chairman vacates office, hands over to Ahmed Muazu as acting chairman. Nigerian army redeploys 55 soldiers from fight against terrorism after 5 years. NSAS, AGF keeps mum over freezing protesters' account. Now the news in details. Chairman of the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, Professor Mahmood Yakubu, has handed over the mantle of office to an INEC National Commissioner, Air Vice Marshal Muazu Ahmed, retired despite reappointment by the Nigerian President, Muhammadu Buhari.
The Commission is a constitutional body whose members are appointed for 5 years, which may be renewed for a second and final term. This means that my tenure and that of the first set of 5 commissioners ends today.
Explaining the motive behind his action while stressing the importance of vacating the office at the handover ceremony held recently at the INEC headquarters in Abuja, the country's capital, Professor Mahmood said, quote, "It will be inappropriate for me to remain in office beyond today, 9th November 2020. Without confirmation by the Senate and swearing to another oath of office as provided by law," unquote, admitting that the renewal of his tenure as chairman of the commission has been announced subject to confirmation by the Senate. Professor Mahmood reiterated the trust of the INEC in the electoral landscape of the most populous African nation, saying, quote, "Our work as election managers requires us to enforce the law, regulations and guidelines. In doing so, we must demonstrate strict respect for and compliance with the Constitution of Nigeria and subsidiary laws," unquote. The INEC chair, who voluntarily vacated his office without seemingly pressure from any quarters, explained that the current INEC was inaugurated in 3 batches and himself was sworn in along 5 national commissioners on November 9, 2015, stating that 6 more national commissioners were inaugurated on December 7, 2016 and another on July 21, 2018. He further described the commission as a constitutional body whose members were appointed for 5 years, which may be renewed for a second and final term. The INEC chair, who since appointment after taking over office from Professor Atai Rujega, has conducted many elections, including the 2019 polls, which saw President Buhari staying in the office for another 4 years. Noted that as of the time of the handover ceremony, his tenure and that of the first set of 5 commissioners have ended, he said, quote, "Pending the conclusion of the statutory process, the remaining national commissioners have resolved that AVM Ahmed Muazu, retired, will oversee the affairs of the commission. It is therefore my pleasure to hand over to him in the interim. We have worked as a team for the last 4 years, therefore there is nothing new to any of them," unquote. It should be noted that Professor Mahmood's handover is nothing like a resignation but a decision taken in order to allow the 9th Senate to carry out its process of confirming his appointment alongside the 5 other members of INEC whose tenure have expired but have all been reappointed by the President. 5 years after deployment to the northeastern part of Nigeria for peacekeeping with the mandate to quell the nefariously growing terrorism group Boko Haram, troops of the 192 Battalion of the Nigerian Army have been relieved from battlefield after serving in the Operation Lafia Dole. Some of the men who were relieved recently had fought the counter-insurgency war in the northeast for not less than 5 years since their deployment. A mini the induction ceremony was held in their honor at the headquarters of the 7th Division in my Malari barracks in Maiduguri, the Borno State capital. Commending the soldiers for their outstanding performance, the acting general officer commanding 7th Division, Brigadier General Abdul Khalifa Ibrahim, while giving his remarks, urged the men to remain disciplined as they depart the war zone to reuniting with their respective families and other members of the public. Meanwhile, according to Brigadier General Ibrahim, the battalion will further be inducted at the Nigerian Army School of Infantry, Jaji, Kaduna State. He encouraged the soldiers to go on courses to improve their professionalism and chances of promotion in the service, saying, quote, "When you go back, the way you will interact with the civil populace is different from what you have been doing fighting Boko Haram. You must take into consideration attributes that we expect a soldier to have: discipline, integrity, respect for others, courage, and the rest. We don't want you to go and start fighting people and say you have come from the Northeast," unquote. It is on record that among the major achievements by the troops of the 192 Battalion was their participation in the liberation of Goza, a town in southern Borno, 5 years ago. It is, however, not clear how many of the men were originally posted to the Northeast. In the year 2002, Muhammad Yusuf founded the sect that is now known as Boko Haram in Maiduguri, the capital of the northeastern state of Borno, the northern Nigeria. He established a religious school that attracted poor Muslim families from across Nigeria and neighboring countries, with the center aiming to create an Islamic state, thus becoming a recruiting ground for jihadists. Constituting danger to the peace of northern Nigeria, Yusuf was arrested by the Nigerian security forces, but he died in custody, fueling further crisis until this day, so that the original Boko Haram group now has various factions. The group, since falling out with the Nigerian state, had killed scores of civilians, paramilitary and military personnel, as well as launching attacks on security bases in the northern parts of Nigeria. Recently, a faction of the Boko Haram terrorist group launched attacks on two different occasions against the Borno state governor, Babagana Zulum, in which it was reported that many security personnel lost their lives, but the governor was unhurt and he has vowed not to be intimidated by any attempt on his life. The Attorney General of the Federation, Abubakar Malami, maintained silence when he was questioned recently by journalists on the legality of freezing bank accounts of some of the ENSAS protesters and promoters in the country. The AGF, when accosted by journalists on the legal backing of the action by the Central Bank of Nigeria, CBN, kept mum, smiled, and walked away from newsmen. It was earlier reported that the CBN received an order granted by Justice Ahmed Mahmood to freeze the accounts of about 20 individuals, including an organization linked to the nationwide ENSAS campaign. Persons affected by the action include Bolatito Richard Oduala, Chima David Ibejumo, Ibebunjo, Mary Dose Pengua, Sada Temitope Bibi, Basi Victor Israel, Wisdom Busao Osowo Obi, Nicholas Ikalie Osazeli, Ebere Idibie, Akin Tomide Lanre Yusuf, Owo Ezinwa You Promise, Musokbe Fuluwa Odeseye, Adegoke Pamilerin Yusuf, Umo Grace Ekane, Babatunde Victor Shegun, Mulu Luis Teganan, Mary Oshifowora, Winifred Akpavelgene Jacob, Victor Solomon, Idinun A. Williams, and Gatefield Nigeria Limited. Meanwhile, Chairman Senate Committee on Judiciary, Legal and Human Rights, Okpayemi Bamidele, while speaking with journalists recently on the sideline of budget defense session in